Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and today we have a very special guest on Superstar Save Point. Welcome, Ruby Riot!
That was good.
Is that a thing?
I like that. Can you works? Not do it with your tongue, though?
I can't. I do it with my uvula.
It's like a gurgling.
And that starts to sound like I'm drowning within my own throat. Can you do it?
Yeah.
Can you say a word with it, though?
Yeah. What do you want me
Can
to
do? Can you say Ruby Riot?
Riot. Yeah.
Oh.
You're good at it. Try it.
Riot.
So close, but you're just moving your tongue on the top of your mouth.
We're playing Turtles in Time.
Yes, we are.
Okay, so everybody on the show has a nickname.
Okay.
First, these shoes.
These shoes.
What?
These shoes.
Those are so good.
But look at the comparison, though. Like, the size. Whoa.
Yeah.
The size. I wear children's shoes.
Why do you wear such little shoes?
Because I have little feet.
Has it always been like that?
My whole life.
What would you like your nickname to be?
My nickname is Ruru. That's what Liv Morgan calls me all the time. Ruru. She says it just like that.
So I feel like we have to say it like that. So okay.
Every time.
Ruru. Welcome, Ruru. Yay. Okay, so we're playing Turtles in Time. And Ruru. Do you have a favorite Ninja Turtle?
Duh.
Who's your favorite?
Mikey, though.
Mikey's? Why Mikey?
Mikey, like, okay. So Splinter always used to say, like, that because he was, like, the most chill and, like, the most, like, focused on, like, relaxed on partying and pizza and stuff, like, he was the best fighter. And I have to agree with that.
Oh.
He's got to be relaxed.
Okay.
He's all uptight like Raphael.
Exactly. I'm not a Raphael guy.
He's the worst. Everybody loves him, and he's the worst turtle.
Oh, he's so upset. Do you want to chime in? You want to chime in, Brian? My favorite is obviously Donatello.
I would peg
he's
you
smart
for
and can fight. Guy. Yeah. See, but Leonardo.
Just too bossy.
Yeah. He's good as the leader because he needs to be able to lead.
Yeah.
I feel like Michelangelo. He's my second favorite. He's like he's my life choice.
Yeah.
But my
like
logic choice.
Yeah.
And then Raphael, I can just do without him.
He's just always getting people into trouble.
Yeah, that's
what
it.
Are you doing
he's just dragging the team
life.
Down.
That's all you're
just
doing.
Dragging the whole team down.
Down.
Cause you're a Michelangelo girl.
Yes.
Fair.
Absolutely.
Fair. When you were a kid, was Michelangelo your favorite, or did that change?
No. Okay. Mikey has always been my go-to guy.
Okay.
For sure. He was always the comedic relief, which is always the best.
You always need that.
I always need that. You know.
Okay. Ninja Turtles. So, were there other cartoons that you were into?
As a kid, I was a huge like Rugrats fanatic.
Ooh, nice.
I did love the Rugrats and the Nicktoons in general.
Yeah.
The '90s were just such a great time.
Just the best.
I loved Rocko's Modern Life. Mm-hmm. Aerial Monsters was my jam.
Yes. Yes. There
primarily,
was.
I like CatDog, Angry Beavers.
Okay, so I feel like CatDog doesn't get enough credit.
It
CatDog
doesn't.
Was
it was
incredible.
Great. It was great. It was really well written.
Someone tried to tell me that CatDog was the worst Nicktoon that came out.
Yeah, that person is wrong.
Yeah.
It just lives in wrong town.
But then I couldn't think of like what would be the worst Nicktoon cartoon that came out. Because it's not CatDog.
It's not CatDog.
But it's I don't know if it's not CatDog. Because all of them were
they
good.
They were so good, though. They all were good in their own right, you know?
Yeah.
That was like, they were all good in their own category.
Yeah.
Hey Arnold was bomb.
Hey Arnold was great. Did you see they released a new movie?
I heard about it.
Yeah. And so, it like tells what happened to his parents?
Yeah. So I read online, like that was always the worst part is like, as you get older, you can go on Facebook and read these like, this is where the cartoon actually came from.
Oh, yeah,
and the
yeah.
backstories. And they're always the most depressing, morbid crap you've ever heard in your whole life. Hey Arnold was about a boy who was born with a deformity that caused his head to be that size.
Yeah, yeah.
And all this terrible stuff. And then like something about Cynthia, who was Angelica's doll, was like her like mom who was into drugs and stuff. Like it was awful.
Well, so like there's like those scary stories. So like with the Rugrats stuff, there's the theory that the Rugrats are all, they were never alive. They were all dead.
Yeah, it's the most morbid crap.
They're just figments of Angelica's imagination.
It's awful, man.
But when you go back, when you read those and you go back and watch the shows, like.
It makes sense.
Yeah,
it makes too much sense for life.
Oh, I think the other, it wasn't Nicktoons, but it was the story of Peter Pan.
Oh, really?
So like the first thing you see Peter Pan do in the movie is you see him kidnap a child. You don't think about it like that.
You don't think about it like that.
He's taking her to Neverland.
Yeah.
He's kidnapping a child. So Peter Pan is actually a demon who steals children's souls.
That's
why they don't grow up. He steals them so they're in this demon land and they never grow up. Hook is the only child that got away, and in the fight, he lost his hand. Peter Pan cut his hand off, and Hook is trying to save these kids.
What?
It's messed up, right?
It blew my mind.
It changes everything. Peter Pan's a horrible villain.
Yeah, and Hook's the good guy. Yeah. He's the hero.
Yeah.
Terrible.
So there's like a full website of stuff like that. It's crazy.
The one that was actually true was that I realized and found out that Rocko's Modern Life was probably the most messed up show on television in the 90s. And none of us realized.
No.
Nobody realized.
But the thing is, like, we all watched the show, and, like, my parents watched these cartoons with me. They never said a word. Like, did they not notice?
There's no way that they couldn't have. There's no way that they couldn't have noticed.
It's just so strange to me.
It's crazy. And I think just back then, like, everything was so much more chill.
Yeah, this is true.
People weren't doing the things that they do these days. Kids are just...
They're doing too much now.
They are.
Kids, y'all gotta relax.
Y'all chill out.
You gotta calm down.
You guys gotta chill. Get yourself some Nicktoons.
Yeah.
Some Fruit Loops cereal.
Something.
What kind of cereal
Fruit Roll-Up,
like?
Fruit by the Foot. Cereal?
Yeah.
Forever on Cocoa Krispies.
Cocoa Krispies. See, I liked the Cocoa Krispies were great, but they just mushed so fast.
That's fair.
They were so, like, they got oatmeal so fast. I was really into when it was around. It's not around anymore. Was the French Toast cereal?
Did you ever Cinnamon Toast Crunch? That?
Yeah. No, it was French Toast.
Just straight up French Toast.
They were shaped like little pieces of bread.
What?
Yeah, it was. Dude, you never mess with that.
Do you know what this?
It's back? Stop. Don't mess with me. Hey. You don't joke about that.
So if that information is true, and Sean wouldn't lie about that, he's looking it up right now, we will obtain a box of this cereal for you as a thank you for being on the show.
That's the best.
We got you. We like to give gifts.
So great.
We like to give gifts.
Dude, it's the best. Dude, it was the greatest cereal just ever.
Who made it?
I want to say Kellogg's, but I don't know.
Oh, just straight up French Toast.
So
it's General Mills, like Cinnamon Toast Crunch, but just straight up French Toast Crunch.
So good.
That's
so good.
How I never once heard of that.
It's the greatest cereal. It tastes like Little Bits of French Toast.
Did you ever like the knockoff cereals, like Count Chocula?
Of course I did. My parents were so broke growing up. That's all we had were the knockoff versions. I went to my friend's house to get the
good
stuff.
There you go, get the good cereal. So, well, there's no sugar in this.
Yeah. Why is your friend eating so many boxes? Just let her have it, Mom.
Yeah,
just
let
her
fine.
Have it.
It'll
she
be
doesn't
fine.
Get the good stuff.
That's what my friend's mom realized. That she could take, like, the healthy bags of cereal that were, like, $1.50 instead of buying Cocoa Krispies, which were, like, $6. She'd buy that bag and keep the one Cocoa Krispie box. So we, like, she'd try to, like, test us like we wouldn't know. And
did you guys figure it out?
Like, 6 months down the road. And she's like, you guys didn't even realize. I was like, yeah, we would. She's like, you've been eating this for 6 months. Like, how could you?
Lied to us for so long.
The betrayal.
Terrible.
We were so hurt. But it was good. So serious. We're just doing a 90s cartoon style episode.
The greatest.
Okay, so you watch the Nicktoons. You like the cereal.
Yeah.
Did you have a favorite show, like, in your Saturday morning lineup of cartoons?
So my favorite, my go-to one always was the Rugrats. Whenever I heard that song, I would pop in front of the TV and just, like, dance to the little, like, so I loved the Rugrats. But the Saturday nights when I wasn't supposed to stay up, I loved all that.
Ooh. You weren't supposed to be up watching all that?
No. My mom was just afraid of everything.
There was rap music in the beginning.
Exactly. I had a bunch of stuff. In the mornings, though, a lot of times, sometimes when my mom didn't want to watch cartoons and she was home because she, like, worked late and stuff.
Yeah.
And this is one of our main things we have in common with the Golden Girls.
Yes.
I
oh my God.
Watching early episodes, you go on Lifetime and watch just like the marathons of the Golden Girls.
So good.
And
the fact that it's on Hulu right now, so I've started watching it from the beginning again. I have the box set.
Tell me you don't get choked up at the season, like the series finale. Like, tell me you don't get a little choked up
when
she doesn't come back through.
Of course I do. Of course.
She doesn't.
I get choked up. So, like, I just started watching again, and I'm on. We just watched episode 3, and that's when Blanche is gonna get married to that guy, but then he realized he has 6 wives and like 7 places, and that almost.
That gets you.
Yeah, because Blanche was so happy.
She was so happy. She was so ready, and then she's just like. She wants to be buried with what was his name? Mr. Pincus.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She wants to be married with Mr. Pincus. She's like, I'll never have to look anybody in the eye again. Well, except maybe Mr. Pincus. Rose was always the worst when you needed comfort.
Just horrible.
She was terrible.
God. I want to meet.
She's like
Betty
Sarah.
So bad.
Sarah Logan's a lot like Blanche.
What?
She's terrible when it comes to like.
She Blanche
her,
or Rose?
She's like Rose.
I was like,
she's
okay, there's like there's two very.
Yes, sorry. She's like Rose. I was very invested in what's happening right now. I'm trying not to die, but
it's hard to talk and play.
Yeah, it's great though. So oh no, you're fit. But yeah, no, she's like Rose when it comes to that. When stuff's happening, she's great at like she's very like supportive and like great. But she sometimes says all the wrong things.
And it's just like no, yeah. maybe not.
Maybe not. But yeah, okay, we talked about this. Who's your favorite Golden Girl?
Blanche. By far. I'm from the South, so I respect a Southern woman with the utmost of respect.
A good belt.
She lives in my heart. I love her. Oh, I forgot.
You are wearing the shirt.
I didn't even realize.
Appreciated. I didn't even realize. I always appreciate when you wear Golden Girl shirts.
I told her that I was trying to only wear Golden Girl shirts all year.
You had so many for Christmas.
I did.
So jealous.
I have maybe 12 Golden Girl shirts.
I wore one to SmackDown the other day, the one day I didn't see you.
Yeah.
Specifically
Which one
for
was
that
it?
Reason. I don't remember. I think it was just a regular Golden Girl shirt that I got from Target.
Okay.
Like, it was like a light blue one that had the whole.
Oh, this says Stay Golden?
Yep. Stay Golden. That's
what
it was.
I got you.
Yep.
Sasha actually got me a Golden Girl shirt.
Really?
You remember that old NSYNC cover where it just says NSYNC and it's them on the slate?
That doesn't exist in life.
Yeah, it says Squad and it's the Golden Girls. It's so
That's
good.
Incredible.
It's so good.
That might be the greatest shirt in existence.
Yeah, yeah. Like that one, there's one. Where they're set up in like the Queen, like Bohemian Rhapsody style. Yeah.
Whoa, where are you finding these?
I've been searching.
They're gems.
I've been searching.
Man.
I'll put you on. We'll get you a Golden Girls shirt and some French toast.
You guys are too good
French
to
toast
me.
Crunch.
You guys are too good to me.
Okay.
That's just all I got paid in life. I think
through every match, here's a box of French toast crunch.
I'm okay with that.
You're just 400 pounds at the end of the year.
I think I'm okay with that.
Okay, so you do love the Golden Girls. You've got this insatiable
Dorothy.
Love for
Dorothy
them.
Dorothy was my girl.
Dorothy. Okay.
No, most
Dorothy.
People don't like.
Okay.
Most don't like Dorothy, but
she's the reasonable one.
She's the reasonable
yeah.
one. I am that in the squad.
Oh
like,
yeah.
I have to be the Dorothy. Blanche is Liv. I'm Dorothy. Sarah's Rose. The squad is the Golden Girls. For
so you
sure.
need a Sophia.
I do need a Sophia. Do you want to be our Sophia?
I would love to be your Sophia. Is that like some weird thing to say?
I would love to be your Sophia.
I have been trying for 2.5 years now mm-hmm. to when we were at a convention, me, Kofi, and E, to get them to dress up like the Golden Girls with me. But we need a
so
fort.
Who's who?
I'm Blanche.
Obviously.
Then I think that Kofi is definitely he's definitely Dorothy.
Is he? He's
yeah.
the reasonable one.
Definitely Dorothy.
Okay.
Then I don't know. He's like a mix of all of them, so I don't know.
I feel like this needs to be eventually one day. This needs to be like a competition.
I need
it. So like Squad versus New Day, who can be better Golden Girls?
Oh my God! But do we each get to pick a fourth?
Yes.
To add to our crew.
We have like a random wild card.
Okay. Fourth. Okay. I like a random wild card.
I'm digging it.
Do we pick your wild card?
Ooh,
and we and you pick
and
ours.
Then we pick yours.
Yeah.
Done.
So we're just picking
Done.
The worst.
So
possible.
It's good potentially for the other. But that's gonna be the hardest part about this is gonna be explaining to Liv what the Golden yeah. Girls is.
What?
She's 22 years old.
What?
She doesn't know what the Golden I don't know. She might.
No,
she
no
might.
Offense to all of you
no
youngins on
to
YouTube.
Youngins, no.
All you millennials.
But if you don't know
your
the
avocado
Golden
sandwiches.
Girls, go on Hulu now and watch it for the rest of your lives.
Yes. Yes.
You'll learn some life lessons and maybe then y'all
you
will calm down.
They'll teach you how important it is to buy a house instead
to
of traveling.
To buy a house instead of traveling, to
Travel
always
later.
Get wicker furniture.
Always. Oh no.
Oh God.
Golden Girls teaches good lessons, all these
it
Nicktoons
really does.
Teach good lessons.
They do though.
All that teaches lessons. Do you watch any current cartoons, like Steven Universe or anything like that?
I love Adventure Time.
Adventure Time is very good.
I love Adventure Time. I like Rick and Morty.
Okay.
Did
you watch this whole last season?
I haven't yet.
Okay.
No, I got to get caught up, to be
okay.
honest. So I just want to side note real quick.
Yes.
My favorite thing about Bebop and Rocksteady is the part in the movie where Splinter sees him. He's like, they're babies. Yeah. I don't know why that is my favorite part.
This is when I wish we could like use copyrighted footage and just splice that in as you say it.
Babies.
So when I was a kid and we played this game, so... like you have Toka and Rezar in this, mm-hmm. but not Bebop and Rocksteady.
Yeah.
We were always so confused. It was just like
yeah.
mad, but then I started to love Toka and Rezar.
Yeah.
So
they reminded me of them. I they're the best.
Okay, so yeah, so we're Rick and Morty, Adventure
Rick and
Time.
Morty, Adventure Time. And then I'm in like I like the obviously the adult cartoons. Those are the ones that I always like to like go to sleep to, like Family Guy, South
yeah.
Park. I love Bob's Burgers.
Bob's Burgers
is
so good.
Life. For
do
me.
You do you relate with Tina?
Tina's like my spirit animal.
We have a Tina.
Aw, Tina.
Just because you're making
do
that
like
face.
Butts? like, we all like butts. Your ass is gross.
Yeah. You can say that. That's good. Tina is easily my favorite character of that show.
She's the best. Louise is a close second, though.
Louise is really good.
Louise is a close second. I get annoyed with Gene. Fairly easily.
Yeah.
But I understand his humor.
Yeah. It's like I'm over Gene after I watch like a yeah. full episode of Gene.
Yeah.
Like
he's too much.
What did he do? He like put his farts on his keyboard so he could play like a fart musical.
Terrible.
And it's like, okay, like I'm done with this. But then it's like the whole thing and I'm like, all right, Gene, let's go.
Nobody knows this, but Linda is my mother. Oh, like not in real life, obviously.
Oh, I was like, how's that work out for you?
If you watch that show, Linda is Mama Riot, because she's nuts, for one. All right. She, like, sings everything that she's ever said in her whole life. Everything has to be a musical. Everything has to be overly dramatic. Like, she, like, every time I see her on one of those episodes, I'm like, oh, God, it's my mother.
Oh, why?
Oh, no.
Why?
It's a cartoon version of my mother.
They should pay her royalties.
No, they should. They really should. She literally sings every word she's ever said.
So was she like a singer or did she like musicals?
She loved musicals. She loved like singing and dancing and acting. That's why she threw me into it when I was a kid.
Okay, that was my next question. Did you
yeah,
go down that path?
That was where I usually went because I wasn't good at sports.
Okay.
I really wasn't. The only thing I was like, the only sport I was good at was pro wrestling.
Yeah.
Like everything else I tried and I didn't make the team. I tried a bunch.
But you were in theater performances.
Yeah. I did theater. I did a lot of theater in college
okay.
and in high school and stuff.
Okay.
And my mom is just the most overdramatic human being. Oh, sorry. Oh, God. It's too much. It's too much.
Flat back on this concrete stage. Immediate regret.
I swear.
Stop.
I
no,
swear.
You're not telling me the truth right now.
I promise.
Da 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 da